Did I make it? Is Mr. Zangler still here?
Yeah, you still got 5 minutes.
Great.
Bobby, what happened?
Oh, they kept me late at the bank. But I've got my tap shoes on. This time Zangler's gonna be dazzled. He's gonna hire me on the spot. Mr. Zangler!
And gentlemen, well, 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 my name is Bella Zangler. Woo! Woo! Thank you for coming to Zangler Follies, our final performance of the season. And I hope you will all be here in just 8 weeks for a wonderful new show. Tessie.
Mr. Zangler, could I see you?
I must talk now to dance director about very important professional matter.
Right.
Tessie?
Yes, Mr. Zangler.
Tessie, I love you.
Bella.
But you say we have intimate supper.
I'm not hungry.
Tessie, please, you make me crazy.
And how is Mrs. Zangler?
I am sorry to say she's in excellent health.
Right.
Tessie.
Hi, Mr. Zangler.
Not you again.
Yeah, I'm here to audition.
Not now.
Oh, Mr. Zangler, you don't understand. When I go to your office, they throw me out.
Oh, good, I give them a raise.
No, 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 would you wait a second?
Mr. Child, why are you wasting my time?
Because the theater's my life. Yeah, it's all I care about.
Jeez.
Now, look, you are gonna love this, I promise. Just, okay?
Okay.
Here, would you hold this? All right.
Thanks. Here goes.
Let me give you the lowdown. I'm crazy for you. When it comes to a showdown, I'm crazy for you. And so though love may not inspire my lingo, still it's making my heart go bango, bingo.
Big finish.
I'm holding.
What do you say to that?
Foot.
Huh?
Foot.
What?
You are standing on my foot.
I'm sorry.
You are a moron. Stay away from me,
Mr. Zangler, look, I realize I'm an unknown here in New York, but I have potential.
Yeah, you could be unknown all over America.
But you didn't even see my traveling time step.
Just forget about him.
Cheer up. He's not worth it.
Yeah. Who knew he had big feet?
Hello, Bobby.
Irene, hi.
Say goodnight to the ladies, Bobby.
Now, wait a second.
We'll see you later.
We gotta go anyway. Night, Bobby.
Night, Bobby.
Goodnight, Bobby.
Night, Bobby.
Night, girls.
Bobby, it's time you gave up all this dancing nonsense and settled down.
Nonsense?
We have been engaged for 5 years. Now, when are we getting married?
We're not.
Of course we are.
Oh, no, we're not.
Don't be ridiculous. The wedding is already planned and the guest list is up to 900.
Great. Big crowd. You won't even miss me.
We start next week.
Mr. Zangler, I'm sorry about you.
Moron.
Promise me, from the day we're married, you'll work in the bank.
But I don't want to work in the bank. That's my mother's idea. Now, you know that's the whole trouble. Nobody in the theater takes me seriously. Well, if my mother were here right now, you know what I would say to her? Huh? I would say to her, Mother!
Yes, Bobby?
My God, you look well! Oh, that coat.
I knew I'd find you here.
Lottie, dear, I'm talking to Bobby.
Well, so am I.
Then get in line.
Bobby, in the 10 years since you left Harvard, you have accomplished nothing.
He got engaged to me.
You've accomplished less than nothing. Now, the board of directors and I have decided to give you one last chance. If you fail the bank this time, I shall cut off your allowance.
When he's married to me, he won't need an allowance.
No, he'll need a psychiatrist. Now, this is a deed of property.
He'd like it signed.
Oh, fine. Do you have a pen?
Not by you, you idiot! By some other idiot who lives in Dead Rock, Nevada. I want you to go there immediately and get him to sign it.
Nevada?
It will save the bank quite a sum and foreclosure costs.
Oh, but who cares? I want to dance. I don't care about money.
Oh.
I'm sorry, Mother, I'm sorry.
He will go to Nevada over my dead body.
That sounds like an excellent route. Now, Bobby, get in the car.
Dying.
You will go to Nevada first thing tomorrow morning, or I shall cut off your allowance. I don't want to hear any more nonsense about it.
Bad news, go away, call round someday in March or May. I can't be bothered now. My bonds and chairs may fall downstairs. Who cares? Who cares? I'm dancing and I can't be bothered now.
And
I'll
you will find yourself in that allowance, young man. If
and I don't understand
do not
why you
have
to come to Nevada.
Do you hear your mother,
Bobby?
Speak
to me,
Bobby.
I'm up among the stars. On earthly things I frown. I'm throwing off the bars that held me down. When times are riper, just now I shan't, because you see I'm dancing and I can't be bothered. Now.
about nonsense.
So, which is it, Bobby? Me or Dead Rock?
Oh, boy. Oh. Taxi! Grand Central Station!
Bobby!
It's from that stinking bank again.
Oh, dear.
This time they want to take our theater.
I'm afraid we're a little behind on the mortgage.
It says here, if we don't pay them a ton of money by the end of this month, they're going to own it. Lock, stock, and barrel.
Well, now they're going to
change that. I wish you could have seen your mother up on that stage.
I bet she was really something, Dad.
Yeah, she was never more radiant than when she stood there behind those footlights, singing her heart out to a house full of drunken gold miners.
Poor old guy.
Just look at this. They're sending some banker out here to put the knife in. Name of Bobby Child. Ha! Bobby Child. If I ever meet up with that skunk, I'll... Well, I don't know what I'll do, but it's gonna be ugly.
Oh!
I've never seen her that mad before.
Talk about an exciting day.
I guess the train arrived.
Well, it's only an hour's walk from the junction.
No, 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 no. I can't let you have the theater, Lank.
I want you to let me have it. I want to buy it for my
wife. I wish you could have seen Polly's mother up on that stage, standing there behind the footlights.
Stop blabbering, you pig-headed fool.
Lank Hawkins, don't you dare talk to my father that way.
Okay. Okay, look, I'll make it simple. I own the saloon.
I know that.
Good. Now, being a man of vision, I'd like to expand the saloon in the direction of your theater, which, if you'll recall, was turned into a post office 20 years ago.
Oh, I would love to see a show in that theater again.
Everett, it's not going to happen. In 2,000 years, there has been one resurrection, and it wasn't a theater. Think of it, Everett. This could be a big town again. Shops and cafes, sidewalks. We could have another Hudsonville on our hands.
But it's such a nice town as it is.
You look around, for God's sakes. We have a town full of singing cadavers. We have bodies lying in the street. We are the armpit of the American West.
You listen to me, Lang Hawkins. If you ever yell at my father that way, then I'm gonna skin you alive. You hear me? He is my father, and it's time you showed him a little respect.
Things are looking up. I've been looking the landscape over, and it's covered with four-leaf clover. Oh, things are looking up since love looked up at me.
And he ain't gonna sell you his theater if you don't want to.
Bitter was my cup, but no more will I be the mourner, for I've certainly turned the corner. Oh, things are looking up since love looked up at me.
I've asked you to marry me 15 times.
So ask somebody else.
There is nobody else. You're the only woman within 50 miles.
Oh, Polly!
Come on, Dad, I gotta wash up.
Polly. Polly, my God, that's a wonderful name. See the sunbeams. Everyone beams just because of you. Love's in session, and my depression is unmistakably through. Thank you.
Things are looking up. It's a great little world we live in. Oh, I'm happy as a puff since love looked up. Oh, I'm happy as a puff since love looked up at me.
Rubbish. Complete rubbish.
Oh, come on, Lang. I thought it was pretty good that time.
What's going on here?
Oh, the famous gunfights of the Old West.
It's Lang's idea to help bring in the tourists. See, that there was Wider versus Billy the Kid.
Yeah, but they could have hurt each other.
Are you kidding, mister? These here's blanks. Hey, Lang.
Get down, buddy! Woo!
No wonder this country's in a depression.
Where's Lang?
He's out back.
Who the hell is he?
He sort of crawled into town this afternoon.
How do you do?
Oh, see, he's still a little shaky.
Well, walk him around. Get under him. Oh, here, I'll do it. Come on, sunshine. This way. Now you're getting it. Keep those feet moving. What the hell did you do that for?
I don't know.
Well, don't do it again.
Right.
Hey, Harry, get me a drink so I can clean my lips.
Make that too. I'll have another. Come on. One for the road. Oh.
around here, are you?
That's a little strong.
Strong? We got 30-year-old cows who pass water stronger than this stuff.
My God, you are beautiful. Yeah, you're like the Venus de Milo. Except for your arms. No, I mean, you have arms.
Mister, it's been real nice talking to you.
Oh, don't go.
Maybe I'll see you again sometime in a rocket ship or something.
Have some pity on an Easterner. Show a little sympathy. No one possibly could be sterner than you have been with me. Oh, no. There's a job that I'm applying for. Let me put it to you thus. It's a partnership I'm dying for, Mr. and Mrs. Us.
No.
Before you file it on a shelf, let me tell you of myself. Oh, I'm the chappy to make you happy. I'll tie your shoesies and chase your boozies. Oh, lady, would you tell me, could you use me?
No nightlife for you, the birds would bore you, the cows won't know you, a horse would throw you. You silly man, you'd ask me, can you use me?
Do you realize what a good man you're getting in me? I'm no elk or mason or woodman who gets home at 3.
Your ties are freakish, your knees are weakish. Go back to flappers and hide the lappers. Though you can use me, I most certainly can use you.
Wait. Drop that long face, come on, have your fling. Why keep nursing the blues? If you want this old world on a string, put on your dancing shoes, stop wasting time. Put on your dancing shoes, watch your spirits climb. Shall we dance or keep on moping? Shall we dance and walk on air? Shall we give in to despair? Or shall we dance with never a care? Hey! Life is short, we're growing older. Don't you be an also-ran. You'd better dance, little lady, dance, little man. Dance whenever you.
Thank you.
Oh, Polly, where are you? Oh, my God. Just look at this place.
It's something, huh?
It's incredible.
When I was a little thing, I'd watch all the big shows, the lights, the music.
I've never seen anything like it. What's it doing in Dead Rock?
This here used to be a pretty big town about 50 years ago. But then the mines ran out, and most people just kind of got up and left.
Hey, look at this stuff. Oh, my God. You can't let the bank take this place.
How do you know about it?
Oh. I couldn't help overhearing, you know, out on the street. Hey, wait a sec. I've got an idea.
About what?
I know what to do.
What the hell are you talking about?
It's simple. All you need to do to save this place is just put on a show right here in the theater. That'll raise all the money you need to pay off the mortgage.
Just put on a show.
Right.
In here.
Right.
Is everybody this stupid back east, or are you just special?
Well, why not? Hey, don't you ever go to the movies? Mickey Rooney does it all the time. Look, the guys in the bar can sing. I heard them. And I can bring dancers from Zangler's Follies. They're my friends. They come in a second. They're on vacation.
You mean Bella Zangler?
Yeah.
Dad's talked about him. Do you know him?
Do I know him? Are you kidding me? We're like this.
Do you think he'd come out here and put on a show? I mean, if you asked him?
No. But we don't need him. I could do it, I promise. Polly? Please, let me try it. I could accomplish something. And this theater, just imagine giving it a whole new life.
I guess we can try it.
Hey, I'll call the girls first thing in the morning. Watch this.
You're standing on my foot.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, darn.
That's okay. It sure is nice of you to help like this. I mean, we hardly know each other. I'm Polly Baker.
I'm Bobby Child.
What?
Bobby Child.
From New York City.
Right. Oh! What did I do?
You're from that bank.
Oh, I can explain that.
You're here to take our theater, ain't you? This is a trick.
No, it's not.
How could you do this to me?
Polly, you're wrong.
You and your singing and your dancing and your Bella Zanglers.
I can save this theater.
Just go away. And don't you ever let me catch you talking to me again.
Polly. You and your singing and your dancing and your Bella Zanglers. Bella Zangler. Bella Zangler.
Well, well, well. Girls, it is time we pay visit to Dead Rock, Nevada, yeah? Thank you. good morning. This is Dead Rock Nevada, yes?
Yes!
Excellent. I am looking, please, for a Miss Polly Baker.
Well, I'm Polly Baker. What's going on?
Permit me to introduce myself. My name is Bella Zangler.
Get out of here! Are you really Bella Zangler? I mean, what are you doing here?
I am saving theater.
What? Whoa, whoa, whoa.
I am getting a call 3 days ago from a very good friend of mine, Bobby Child. By the way, he is a wonderful boy. You should get to know him, yeah?
He did say you were friends.
Friends? We are like this.
That's just what he said.
I'm not surprised. So, when do we start? We have a show to put on, yeah?
Yeah!
I don't believe one word of this.
Which word is that?
Something smells fishy to me.
I think it's moose.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Oh, my goodness. Mr. Zangler?
You know me?
Well, I've seen your picture in Variety 100 times. Oh. What are you doing here?
We came to help so we can pay the bank.
Well, this is miraculous.
This is ridiculous.
Oh.
I am insulted. Do you want me to put on show or not? I am busy man.
Oh, well, yes, of course.
Okay, I do it. Your girls, to work.
See this gun?
Yeah?
It tends to have a mind of its own.
One out of two ain't bad.
That isn't funny.
Wait!
Mister, I want you out of this town in 24 hours.
Oh, I wish you could have seen Polly's mother up on that stage. Standing there behind the footlights.
Mr. Zangler, if you really can save this place, Well, I guess I'm going to be mighty grateful.
Oh, let's hope so. Yeah? So, who would like to audition? Who be in show? To work with girls.
Yes!
Man, you should marry.
Dad, would you cut it out? When I'm ready to get married, I'll let you know.
By that time, you'll have to contact me through medium.
There's a saying old says that love is blind. Still, we're often told, seek and ye shall find. So I'm gonna seek a certain lad I've had in mind. Looking everywhere, haven't found him yet. He's the big affair I cannot forget. Only man I ever think of with regret. I'd like to add his initials.
Won't you tell him, please, to put on some speed? Follow my lead. Oh, how I need someone to watch over me. Someone to watch over me. In 10 minutes.
Oh, heck, another rehearsal. I've been ready for a whole week.
Gaiety Theater and U.S. Post Office. The show opens tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Just get off at the junction, then it's about an hour's walk. Hello? Hello?
Well, well, well. The busy bee is hard at work.
Frank! This here is a theater and a post office. You can buy a ticket or a stamp, otherwise go back to your saloon.
Holly, you're wasting your time. The show is doomed. Do you honestly think that anyone's going to pay good money to see a bunch of singing numbskulls?
Hands up, hands together, hands on
hands! Hey, morning, Polly!
Morning, Pete.
Now, what does this man know about the theater?
Lay off him, Lank.
Well, perhaps you would tell us, sir, your views on the contemporary American stage.
Well, heck... I don't know.
I don't know. I'd say that's fairly trenchant.
I suppose you could say that Eugene O'Neill is just beginning to explore the symbolism of Greek tragedy. Of course, the realism of Anton Chekhov is still a pretty important influence. Oh, and then there's Stanislavski.
Thank you.
Bye,
Polly, come back here. Polly.
Oh, headstrong, ain't she? Kind of reminds me of that gal in King Lear.
Stop this show if it's the last thing I ever do.
Come over here.
The name's Moose.
Okay, Moose. I got good news, and I got bad news.
What's the bad news?
You will not be dancing in this number.
What's the good news?
be dancing in this number. Be Yasha Heifetz of the Old West. Yes, with politics in Texas and people grinding axes, there's no happiness. Yes, it's only your eggs. Come, the future doesn't threaten me if I can only get me someone to grab that place.
Happiness is not a riddle when I'm listening to that big bass.
Better off. top.
What?
That was joke.
Lunch.
Not too shabby, kiddo.
Whoa.
Excuse me. I'm looking for someone named Bobby Child.
I haven't seen him lately. Maybe you should try Wyoming.
Bobby!
Irene, hi.
What the hell are you doing?
I'm putting on a show. I'm Bella Zangler.
You look like Karl Marx. Why in God's name are you dressed like some idiot in the middle of Nevada?
Mr. Zangler? Hi, excuse me. I just gotta tell you, I mean, what you're doing here, it's like a miracle.
Thank you.
I'll be back in a minute. I gotta get these flyers off to Scabla.
Oh, boy. Oh, take your time!
I should have known.
Irene.
You're doing this for her.
Well, not exactly.
Bobby, I saw that revolting look in your eyes, like a cow who needs milking.
Irene.
And I'm sure she'd love to know all about the real you.
Hey, you wouldn't do that.
We are leaving here tomorrow morning.
Now, just one second.
Bobby, yeah. You are talking to a very frustrated woman.
I can see that.
Mr. Zangler.
Oh. Polly.
Sorry.
No, Polly. We have a visitor. Oh. Polly is the only woman living in Dead Rock.
I guess that's why she looks so tired.
Polly, this is a very old friend of mine.
Well, she sure moves good for her age.
My age. I suppose you just had your coming out party.
Oh, I never had a coming out party. I never even knew what that word meant till I saw that dress of yours.
Oh.
Would you like to borrow it?
Well, not till I'm buried.
Oh, she was making a joke.
I suppose it would look rather odd to you, not having any leather fringe on it.
Oh, that's okay. Your hair kind of makes up for it.
Oh, I just knew you two would be good friends.
Excuse me, Mrs. Angler. Speak with you for a moment.
Yeah.
You, I want you out of here on the next train.
You don't like show?
No, I don't like show, and I don't like you hanging around my woman all day.
You would prefer it all night?
Maybe you'd better take a look at something, huh? Read that.
Oh, well, it looks like a wedding license.
Have I made my intentions clear enough for you?
Well, I guess so, but I just don't want to marry you.
You are close to an idiot. That isn't funny.
Fine. Now leave my theater.
I'm warning you, Zang.
Get out of here now. I am busy man.
You have not seen the end of me.
If it's like the front, I don't want to see it.
Excuse me. You don't by chance have a hotel in this town?
Well, as a matter of fact, I own that beautiful hotel right next door.
Oh, good. You can give me a room and a bath.
Madam, I can give you a room, but you're going to have to take your own bath.
Oh, for God's sake.
Oh, Polly, we have important talk now, yeah?
Sure, what's up?
All right, I want to speak to you about Bobby Child.
Him.
Polly, now he is a wonderful boy. Handsome, talented, brave.
I ain't even seen him for days, which is lucky for him.
Hey, Polly.
Polly, now he has told me that he is crazy for you.
Well, I can't help that. I'm already spoken for.
You are?
Yeah, in my heart anyway.
Oh, it is that lank person, yeah? I tell you, I do not like
him. Oh, it isn't lank!
Moose?
You just don't understand anything, do you? Dozens of men would storm up. I had to lock my door. Somehow, I couldn't warm up. What was it that controlled me? What kept my love lively?
Like,
my
Mister, listen to the rhythm of my heartbeat.
Uh-oh.
And you'll know just what I mean.
Polly, you are making a big mistake here.
Embrace me, my sweet embrace.
I think we gotta have a talk about this, yeah?
Embrace me, you irreplaceable you.
This is not what I was planning.
Just one look at you, my heart.
Oh, no.
See in me. You and you alone bring out the gypsy in me.
Well, that's because I am Hungarian.
I love all the many charms about
you. You are making a big joke now, yeah?
Above all, I want my arms about you.
Okay, it's not a joke.
Don't be a naughty baby. Come to Polly, come to Polly, do.
Now just imagine, if I was Bobby, yeah?
You dance even better than he does.
Oh. No, I don't think so.
But hang it, come on, let's glorify love. Ding dang it, you'll shout and glorify love. Don't be a naughty baby. Come to Polly, do.
With the wrong man.
Oh, God!
Why am I so much better as Zangler?
Everett, would you listen to me?
I'm not interested.
$300 if you call off the show.
Keep your money, Lank.
All right, $400.
Invest in something. Open a casino.
Don't be stupid. Who would come to Nevada to gamble? Your problem.
It's both our problems. If this show succeeds, you could lose Polly and I could lose Bobby.
Who's Bobby?
Zangler.
Bobby Zangler.
His name is Child.
Child Zangler.
No, you idiot! Zangler is Child.
Well, he certainly acts grown up.
You are so stupid.
I'm stupid.
Everybody being an angel child.
God's sake, do something.
Would you stop nagging? I'm not your husband.
Oh, if you were my husband, I'd kill myself.
Quick, find a minister.
I did not come here to be insulted.
Oh, where do you usually go?
Nice one. Real good.
Oh, Dad, where's Bella? He should be here for this. Bella? Bella?
Polly, oh. I was just upstairs talking to Bobby.
Well, not now.
Now, but Polly, he is just so full of energy and vision. He is a doer.
That's for luck.
Oh, here they come. Two rounds in the back. Oh,
chap in somewhere in the desert.
You know, frankly, I'm not sure he'll make it.
Do you mean there's just the two of you?
I'm afraid so. Is that a problem?
No, that's okay. I guess you want to buy your tickets now.
Tickets?
To see the show.
We're not here to see a stage show.
You're not?
No. You see, we're writing sort of a guidebook to the American West.
Oh, we hope to do a series of them.
The name is Fodor. I'm Eugene, and this is Patricia.
Now, let's see. We're here to review the Lank Hawking Saloon Bar Hotel and Restaurant.
Well, how do you do? Lank Hawkins, proprietor of said establishment.
Oh, look at us!
Yeah, are we still in time for dinner, Mr. Hawkins?
Absolutely not. Bonsoir, entree. The clouds part, and justice reigns supreme.
I don't get it. After all that rehearsing?
Maybe some people are coming by car.
No, I wouldn't count on it.
I believe I owe you all a very big apology, yes?
No, it's not your fault.
But it was, I'm afraid. You see, I have put on show, and I raise your hopes, and I do not sell for you a single ticket. I am truly sorry.
Now wait a second! So what if we didn't sell any tickets? That doesn't mean we're a failure.
In the theater business, it's a pretty good indication.
Well, not out here it ain't. I mean, look at what you've given us. Just look around. Before you showed up, we were nothing but a bunch of lazy drifters. We didn't do anything. Then you came along and something magical happened. We've been working together and caring about things and feeling alive. Days can be sunny with never a sigh. Don't need what money can buy. Birds in the tree sing their day full of song. Why shouldn't we sing along? I'm chipper all the day, happy with my lot. How do I get that way? Look at what I've got.
Ladies and gentlemen, if any of you are golfers, I hope you will pick up one of the flyers that is at each of the entrances to the Van Singel for the Warren Reynolds Memorial Golf Outing. Warren is a very significant force, I think, for West Michigan with Positively Michigan, and we dearly miss him, and this season has been dedicated in his memory. And so I hope that you'll pick up one of those flyers, especially if you're a golfer. Right now, I want to say if any of you would like a program mailed to you, please sign up at the box office window. We'll have a list there. And I just want to say I can't believe this has happened tonight during my favorite show. The one show I've been looking forward to the most this entire season was Crazy for You, because I love the music with Gershwin, and I love the tap dancing. We had programs printed and delivered, but somehow they disappeared, and I have no explanation. They are gone. So we do appreciate all of our sponsors and our advertisers very much, and apologize to them and to you. And want to thank you for coming tonight. Again, if you want a copy of the program, we'll have them made up because we do have the original still, and just sign up at the box office window. Thank you for coming tonight, and I hope you are enjoying the show. Enjoy the rest of the second half now.
Marvelous, wasn't that wonderful, Mike?
laundry? No. Problem. Enchanté.
And we'd like a wake-up call, please, at 5 a.m.
5 a.m.?
Yes, we just love seeing the dawn breaking out here in the west.
Right.
Good night, all.
Yes, nighty
night. Yeah, good night. Sleep well and quickly.
Polly? Polly?
I'm having a drink.
Polly, I've got to talk to you. This is important.
What's up?
Polly, look, I've really thought about this, and well, it could be my last chance. Polly, I want you to marry me.
Bobby!
Look, I realize the show didn't work.
It's not that.
But I can get a job out here, and we'll raise the money.
You can't do that.
Of course I can. Are you kidding me? I'll be a cowpoke. Yeah, I'll learn to poke cows. Oh.
Bobby, the fact is I'm in love with Bella.
Polly.
Out there in the street just now was like a celebration of what our show might have been like thanks to him.
Polly.
I just can't help it. Whenever I'm with him, I feel something strange sort of down in my basement. I'm sorry, Bobby.
Polly. Polly, come here. I gotta tell you something.
What?
You're not gonna believe this.
What?
I'm Bella's angler.
Huh?
I'm Zangler. Me, I'm him.
Wait.
No, see? Remember that first day when you got so mad at me? Well, I realized then that there was only one way that I could help, so I called up Tess. And she's the one who brought the clothes and the beer. And that's who you fell in love with.
Bobby, this is pathetic.
But it's true.
How can you stand there and just lie like this?
All right. I'll do the accent for you. Well, 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 it is very nice to see you.
You are
tonight.
Making such a fool of yourself.
We have rehearsed on our own.
This is so sad.
First we practice a little tap.
Bobby, stop it. I just hate
Polly,
this.
You gotta believe me. I'm Zangler.
Oh.
Water, water.
Look, I'll show you the clothes and the beard and the makeup. They're upstairs. I'll prove it to you.
Hi, Bella.
Hi, Bella. And Polly, I wouldn't lie to you. I never. Oh, dear.
Night, Bobby. Nice try.
Hey, Bobby! Are you all right?
Hi.
How do you do?
Oh, my God! Woo! Thank you.
Woo! Night, Bella. Night, Bobby! Bella, what are you doing here?
I don't know, but I'm coming back.
You could ruin everything.
Tessie, I have 3,000 miles just to be with you.
Oh, stop it. Stop it. Will you stop it? Bella, how many times do I have to tell you? I don't enjoy your company. I'm bored when I'm with you, and I don't find you even remotely attractive.
You see, we could be married already.
How is Mrs. Zangler?
She left me.
You're kidding.
She is running around with some stinking louse.
I guess she couldn't break the habit.
Tessie, why do you say such things? You know I would do anything for you.
Anything?
Within reason.
I think I have an idea. Mr. Hawkins.
What?
In case you were wondering, the coffee was cold, the food was inedible, and the cutlery was filthy.
Madam, if you don't like it here, I can show you the wide open spaces.
Oh, I have no desire to look inside your head.
I do not do shows in desert.
Oh, we have the show. We need an audience.
This is middle of no place.
Well, advertise. Get the word out. You could do it.
It is impossible.
Fie. Don't ever kiss this neck again.
Tessie, please, it wouldn't work. This is town of morons.
Oh, that is so typical.
Tessie.
These are nice, normal, healthy people.
Hey, sugar, have at a drink.
You got it, Buster.
Tessie.
Hey, wait a second. That there is my woman. Not anymore. I said, let her go!
Oh,
Tracy, did you see? He went like this and like this and like... Oh, Tessie!
Polly! Polly, you see, it's me! I wasn't lying to you, it's really me! Polly, Polly, Polly!
Tessie! Oh, there's a step. Hey!
No! Safe. Oh. No. Oh. Bartender!
She doesn't want me. Bella, Bella, Bella. Excuse me.
Oh. I am so upset.
I am beside myself.
Women.
Women. Picky, 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 picky. She's so full of trickery. Life is bitter as chicory. Bitterness fills my cup.
I'm sorry you brought that up.
Yeah.
Once I thought I'd search around for the little church around the corner, but now I see
it never was meant to be. Once she used to praise me.
Why is she so high hat?
Why does she amaze me? Tell me what causes that.
When I'm away from her, I start despairing.
Oi, 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 oi.
Ought to know by now what causes that.
Yep, I got a pretty good idea.
I'm growing bolder from the hair I'm tearing.
She!
You ought to
to know by now what causes that. When she keeps on brushing you aside, oh gosh, you're all at sea. You go contemplating suicide, it's much too much for me. You're not so dumb that you don't know the answer. Loving her is what causes that.
Hey, what the hell?
Please, I don't deserve the chair.
If I should climb the Brooklyn Bridge and jump off.
Wait, you're gonna hurt yourself.
That's the idea.
Oh, I suppose you'd ask what causes that.
Oh, that feels good. Ah.
Oh, if I should get a gun and bump this chump.
Oh, no, I think it goes like this.
Not for me.
Oh, I suppose you'd ask what causes that.
Really, you don't have to mope around and burn up as you do. There's a cannon and a rope around, there's lots of poison too. I'm very blue of late and there's a reason. Loving her.
Loving her.
And there's a reason. Loving her is what causes death. Is what causes death. Is what causes death. Is what causes death.
Sell the place to Lank than let that bank have it.
Tea.
Thanks. Hey! Bobby! Oh. Hey, up there! Bobby, you got a telegram!
I got rhythm. I got music. I got headache. Oh. Oh, morning, Polly. Oh, my back! Oh, my legs! Oh, my legs! Stomach, my throat, my nose. Oh, is that my telegram? I bet it's from Mother again. Oh, that is just what I need right now. Dear Fathead, stop.
Yep, it's Mom.
Stop this nonsense, stop. This is your final notice, stop. It sounds like an electric bill. Get back here on next train, stop. Don't stop, stop. We'll stop your allowance if you stop, stop. Your loving mother, stop. Oh, P.S., your uncle stopped by, stop. I wish she'd write letters.
What's the matter? Fellas? Polly, hello?
Is that you?
Oh. Hiya, Bella.
Uh-oh.
Bobby.
Hi. I guess you believe me now.
Wait, are you ready for this? This is the best part.
Ta-da!
Do you also do James Cagney?
Embrace me, my sweet embrace. Well, you remember that? Embrace me, you... Polly! Oh, my God!
that for? You're in love with me. You admitted it.
That was Zangler.
Me?
Not you.
There is third Zangler.
The one I cared about, the real Zangler.
No, that's what I'm trying to tell you. That was me.
You mean you are real Zangler.
No, I'm not the real Zangler.
You mean you are real Zangler?
No, I'm not the real Zangler. I'm Zangler.
Then who am I?
That's what I want to know.
I am not so sure.
I don't even know who I kissed last night.
Me?
Oh, my God.
She kissed you, too?
Of course she kissed me.
Well, had you met her before?
I fell in love with her.
Oh, that must have been some kiss.
Would you stop this?
Stop?
Stop!
Hey, you sound like my mother.
You made a jackass out of me.
No, I didn't.
Of course you did.
I did not.
Maybe I did.
Would you stay out of this?
Polly.
I have never been so humiliated in my whole life.
No, but...
Well, I guess this means you won't be going to the meeting then, huh?
What meeting?
Well, the guy at the theater, we're deciding what to do. She's thinking of selling the place to Lank.
Oh, she can't do that. You have to stop her.
All right.
What time's the meeting?
In about 10 minutes.
I've got to change. Don't start the meeting without me, okay?
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Are you going as me or you?
Me.
That's good. Then I can go as me.
There you are. Are you ready to go now?
No, I can't now. I'm in a hurry.
I've been in this stinking town for 3 days.
Irene, please, I don't have time.
Well, make some time. I am your fiancé.
No, you're not.
Oh, Bobby.
Irene, I'm sorry. It's really over. I'm in love with Polly.
Bobby.
Wish me luck.
Oh, you're a pal.
Bobby, come back here. Bobby!
You haven't seen me.
Weird. Oh, Mr. Hawkins!
You won't be long with that laundry, will you?
No. Too sweet.
And we do hate to bother you again, but we'd like some croissants with our coffee. That won't be too much trouble, will it, dear?
Croissants! No. Suppose if they were found dead tomorrow morning, there might be questions.
It does say hotel, you know, on the sign.
Excuse me?
The sign. Huh? It says hotel.
Does it? Oh, my God, it does? Well, we'll just take care of that, shall we? Like to complain about.
You're a very frustrated man, aren't you?
Oh, I get it. It's Dr. Freud now. Well, doctor, do you know what I really hate? Stupid women from New York who have their brains in their backsides.
Oh, you are without a doubt the rudest, most uncouth, roughest man I have ever met. Come here! Oh, my God! If you prefer a rather swift one,
if you think you'd like to run around.
With the right one, I am just the right one. Naughty baby, who will tease you? I can show the way, know the way to please you. Oh, if you're wanting a beginner, I shan't do. I can make a saint a sinner when I want to. If you find the simple kind rather slow, dear, then you ought to try a naughty one, you know, dear. But you'll never meet another who will be a naughty baby, just like me.
Watching you kids perform. That's how I got started. I tap danced for 10 years.
Wow! I get tired after 10 minutes.
Ever since you kids fixed this place up, I could just look at it all day. It's just like I remember. I wish you could have seen Polly's mother up on that stage.
Standing there behind the glass.
Oh, am I late? Have you started yet?
Just made it.
All right. Now I think that Polly should be in charge of the meeting.
I'd rather not, if you don't mind. I'm just not in the mood right now.
But it's your theater.
Kindly tell Mr. Child that he ain't involved in this without his beard and his funny mustache.
Hey, fellas.
Can someone tell Miss Baker, please, that she happened to fall in love with that mustache?
Like hell I did.
You know you did.
I did not.
Well, this is off to a good start.
I ain't having this meeting with him here.
Yeah, well, you'll have to, because I'm not leaving.
Tess, Tess, me.
Patsy.
Can I go to the bathroom?
Yes.
Ah.
Look, look, the question is simple. We have 2 weeks left. Now, do we try the show again, or don't we? Now, I say we do, huh? Huh? Everett, what do you think?
Oh, dear. Well, you kids work so hard making this place so beautiful again, I think we ought to make that decision together. Polly?
Well, I guess that under the circumstances, we have no choice but to give it up.
How can you say that?
I wasn't talking to you.
Oh, for God's sake.
Well, how do you think I feel, huh? Well, we tried it once and it didn't work.
But we can try it again. Polly, just look around. It's a theater. We can still bring it back to life.
That's it.
Hey, look, to tell you the truth, I just don't have the energy for it.
And it was awfully depressing with only two people showing up.
And they didn't even come for the show.
I think it's kind of a lost cause, if you ask me.
Well, yeah, Christmas means
sort of thing. Stiff upper lip.
Carry on. Chin up.
Stiff upper lip?
Carry on.
Chin up.
Stiff upper lip.
Stout fella.
Carry on.
And fluff.
Chin up.
Keep muddling through.
Stiff upper lip.
When the goblins are off,
hip hip, hip.
Old man trouble and a toodle-oo-too.
Carry on through thick and thin, when you think you're in the fight. Let the fighting spirit win.
Fight, 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 fight.
Stiff up the lip, stout fella. When you're in a stew, sober or bloodle, this is our motto.
Okay, here we go.
That's right.
say aye.
Aye!
All those in favor of forgetting about it?
Aye!
I don't believe you.
Come on, Bobby, you know it won't work.
We already tried it once.
I just don't have the energy.
Yeah, why bother? Nobody comes.
But they will come if you just get the word out a little more, right? Fellas? Patsy?
We tried.
We sure did.
I'm sorry.
It ain't your fault. Entirely.
So long.
Where are you going?
Back to New York.
You're leaving?
Well, there's nothing to keep me here now. Is there?
I guess not.
I guess not. Hey, thanks.
What for?
A lot of fun. A few broken teeth. The way you wear your hat. The way you sip your tea. The memory of all that. No, no, they can't take that away from me. The way your smile just beams. The way you sing off key. The way you haunt my dreams. No, no, they can't take that away from me. We may never, never meet again on that bumpy road to love. Still, I'll always, always keep the memory of danced till free. The way you changed my life. No, no, they can't take that away from me. No, they can't take that away from me.
Writing songs of love, but not for me. A lucky stars above, but not for me. With love to lead the way, I found more clouds of gray than any Russian play could guarantee. I was a fool to fall and get that way. Hey ho, alas, and also lack a day. Although I can dismiss the memory of his kiss.
This is incredible! Tessie, why didn't you tell me?
You would listen!
These men are wonderful! They dance, they sing, they got rhythm.
I told you that!
Okay, we start on show this minute.
Oh,
new posters.
$1,000?
Use picture of pretty girl, it always works. I want buses at junction meeting every train.
Oh, you got it.
We advertise in papers all over state.
In every paper?
In this state, how many could that be? Now, I want everybody on stage for rehearsal in 10 minutes.
Yes!
Stop! And someone clean up this mess. It looks like French Revolution.
So, I was right about these guys, huh?
The cowboys? They're okay.
Okay.
Tessie, I do this for you.
No kidding. That isn't like you.
I know. That's what worries me. Young lady. Young lady.
Huh?
You are a very good dancer.
Thanks.
Where did you learn this?
From a friend.
You are also a good kisser.
Thanks.
By the way, I got big news for your boyfriend. I make him a star of show. Frankly, I thought he was moron. Well, he is moron, but he is talented moron.
He's gone.
Excuse me?
He's gone. He left town.
You are sure of this? Okay, we find someone else. That's show business. You know, you could be star of show.
I don't think so.
Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Good.
It started off so swell. This let's pretend it all began so well. But what an end. The climax of the plot should be the marriage knot. But there's no knot for me.
Fault is hereby defined as a breach of any affirmative or negative covenants contained in Article 5 hereof.
We need Addendum A.
Addendum A.
Addendum B.
Addendum B.
Addendum C.
Addendum C.
Now, where is the appendix?
I think it's about here.
Oh, Bobby, you've been back here for 6 weeks and you haven't learned anything.
I know.
Where's your head?
Dead rock.
I didn't ask what's in it. What's it thinking?
Well, there's this girl.
Not again.
Mother, it's the same one.
Well, forget about her. And remember, whoever you marry requires my prior approval. Now, Bobby, come over here. I have a little surprise for you. We foreclosed on another property. Happy birthday.
Gee, I don't know what. A deed of trust? Wow.
Well, that means you own the property.
Great. Thanks.
Aren't you going to ask me what property?
Okay, what property?
This one.
You're kidding.
This Angler Theater.
Wait, I own the theater?
It's all yours.
Oh, my God.
Well, you always wanted to dance on stage. Now you have a stage to dance on. It's your toy.
Mother, you are wonderful.
Well, hopefully this will keep you here in New York.
It's mine. The whole theater. Every single uncomfortable seat.
I thought you'd like it.
Like it? This is... Wait a sec. What happened to Zangler?
Oh. He couldn't meet the payments. Apparently, he's wasting all his money on that silly little theater in Nevada. I hear he's doing it for some woman.
He's doing it for Tess.
Well, I don't know her name.
Oh, my God.
Gentlemen, shall we look around? Bobby?
Yeah, Mother, I'll be right there. Polly!
Make the board of directors meeting. Well, Bobby, come on!
Holding hands at midnight, 'neath the starry sky. Nice work if you can get it, and you can get it if
one girl, sighing sigh after sigh. Nice work if you can get it, and you can get it if you try. Who can ask for anything more?
Dear, what happened?
I want to go to New York and find Bobby.
You miss him that much?
I do.
Oh, Polly.
Dad, it's taken me 6 weeks to get my courage up. It's now or never. Can you understand that?
I think so.
Thanks! Hostess! I need a ride to the station.
Sure, but ain't you supposed to be on stage?
I don't have time to argue about it. The train's at 8:05. We'll just make it.
Okay.
Dad, I'll call you when I get there.
And...
Oh, dear.
Where is she?
She went to New York. She took the pickup.
But we got full house.
Mr. Zangler, I think they're getting restless. They're throwing fruit at the curtain.
Betsy, go inside to Polly's number.
Yes, sir. Oh, Betsy!
And Zangler, without your show, my cafe goes down the sewer.
I am not magician. I put show on in 3 weeks. I spend all my own money. I lose my theater in New York.
Oh, hi, Bobby.
Hi, Bobby.
Bobby!
Where's Polly? I have to talk to her.
Bobby, how did you get here?
I came in the car.
Well, get back in it and go to station.
Oh my.
I am never buying another foreign car as long as I live.
Holy cow! What happened around here?
The Zangler Folly.
You paid off the mortgage?
We've had full houses for 2 weeks. The problem
is... Oh, my God, Mother, it worked! I accomplished something.
Bobby, show me this woman so I can go home.
All right, I'll be right back.
Bobby, she isn't here. She went to New York to find you.
If stupid machine was working, you could have caught her.
All right,
Stand aside. I'll fix it.
Lonnie!
Irene, what are you doing here?
I live here with my husband.
Oh, that is so typical. You had every chance in the world to get Bobby.
But you were against it.
Well, it would have been better than a cowgirl. You had every opportunity to get Bobby. But all you could do was whine about the mud in your dress.
Things are looking up. It's a great little world we live in. Oh, I'm happy as a pup since love looked up at me. Can I help you, madam?
Well, someone better, I... How very kind of you.
Okay! Wish me luck!
Wait a second, will he make it?
What time is it?
8:05, impossible.
All right, never mind. I can just catch the next train. Get the car on the road. I'm gonna go wash up.
Are those those two ever gonna get together?
I cannot believe this! How the hell could you run out of gas?
I didn't plan it that way.
Well, now what do I do? What do I do now?
Oh, Polly!
Wait a second. I have an idea. Come to me. Come to me.
The one.
Hello? Hey, come on, where is everybody?
Drop that long face, have your fling.
Why keep nursing the blues if you want this whole world on a string? Put on your dancing shoes, stop wasting time. Watch your spirits fly.
Do you want to dance, Bobby?
Who could ask for anything more?
Thank you.
thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to thank you for coming to this evening's performance. Second of all, as many of you may or may not know, each year the Broadway community as cast donates money to Broadway Cares Equity Fights AIDS. This is a charity that helps victims of the disease, people living with the disease, and the research needed to combat this disease. So tonight we're asking for a small donation, whatever you can give, a penny, a nickel, a dime, a quarter, $100. Whatever you can give. Members of our company will be waiting at the exits. They'll have a basket of red ribbons. Please take one as a token of our appreciation, and also to place on your coat or your purse to show your support for this charity. At the end of the tour, we hope to donate a huge check from all of our patrons from across the country. Again, thank you for coming, and we hope to see you all again soon. Thank you.